Performing CRUD operations in Firestore with SwiftUI can be cumbersome due to Firestore async nature, the need for structured data models, and the lack of built-in SwiftUI-friendly API. Managing real-time updates, error handling, and data decoding, encoding adds complexity, making even simple operations feel tedious. This video is the ultimate guide to mastering Firestore CRUD in SwiftUI, breaking down the process step-by-step and providing best practices to streamline database interactions effectively. Make sure to check out the link in the description for my super sale. Now, today I'm going to continue on the previous episode where I set up a model for SwiftUI/Firestore. Go ahead and check out the link for the playlist in the description too. And basically what we have over here is profiles, and we are building up cards. Now, I'm just going to delete all of these cards because I was just testing them. And we are going to create these cards. We are going to do the basic CRUD operations: create, read, delete, and update. So let's just open up Xcode. And this is basically an upgrade on the sign-in with Apple demo. Make sure to check out, again, the other link in the description for the starter project. So it is at github.com/Rebeloper, Firestore sign-in with Apple tree, and then Firestore collection. So this branch right over here, the Firestore collection. Okay, so what do we have right over here? Well, we have three tabs, and on the first one, we are going to fetch with an ID. On the second one, we are going to fetch all of the documents from the collection. And on the third one, we are going to learn about how to use paginated fetches. Usually we are going to, in a production app, you are going to have this type of paginated fetch. Okay, so in the first one, we have the profile view. And previously, I imported Firestore collection as a Swift package. Again, go ahead and check out the previous episode. And Firestore collection will handle everything for us. Let's just import Firestore collection. Import Firestore collection. There we go. And let me just talk a little bit about how all of this works. Well, we are going to create a state variable, and that is going to be called profiles collection. And that is basically going to mimic our structure, what we have right over here on Firestore. So we have a collection, and all of that, like, that collection has a list of all of the documents. Now, right over here in Xcode, let's just type this out, at state private var, and it will be a profiles collection. And this will be a Firestore collection with a path. And the path, I just set it up as a struct with some enums, so there we go. It's a string. Now, this is not enough. We have our path, but we still have to provide our type. So let's just fix this, and I'm just going to add in here the profile model, which I also included right over here. Make sure to check out the previous episode where I set up the model. iOS developers, this is your ultimate chance. I'm bundling all my SwiftUI products into one insane super sale, a 91% discount. Not only do you get everything to code faster and smarter, but I'm also including SwiftUI Camp, my 4-week live bootcamp on Zoom, starting March the 3rd. By the end, you'll be an expert SwiftUI developer. The total value? $2,280. Your price? Only $199. Don't miss out, grab the deal now using the link in the description. Okay, so this is our Firestore collection. This is how we are accessing our collection. How do we grab, let's just say all of, well, just one, let's just fetch our profile in this case. We are going to, this is an asynchronous throwing function, so we are going to need an ID. So what is the ID, this one, of that document? Let's just go back. And basically, we are going to try await, of course, try await, and then profiles collection, you know, that we created, and then type in fetch, and you will see a bunch of options that you can use. The one that we are going to use right over here is the one with ID. Optionally, just add a different animation than the default one. We're going to talk about fetch all next, and first, in the other views. So let's just go with ID and then user ID. Great. So what this will do basically is just fetch our profile. So let me just build and run and see how. Before I build and run, we need to present it on our view. So how does the profile collection display all of its query results? Well, the profiles collection has two variables that we can use. The one is for one object and the other one is for an array of objects. And here we are going to use the one with the one object, and that is the query document. So if let profile, and that is optional, so that's why I'm unwrapping it right over here, profiles collection dot, and then type query documents. Document in our case, we're going to use the documents array later on. So if this exists, so it is not nil, then let's just put this inside the text and then let's just have the UID presented. Why not? Currently, we just have that on the profile. Profile.userID. Okay, so now let's build and run. And basically, after a fraction of a second, we should see this text being presented. Here we go. And as you can see, after half a second, it just populated our user ID. And indeed, this is our user ID. So this is how you just fetch one document, if you have the user ID. But how do you fetch, let's say, all of the documents? This is what we are going to do right over here under all cards. Not only we just have a spinner, and we are also going to do all the CRUD operations with the plus button. That's why we have it right over there. So let's just go to the all cards view right over here. And I just added some stuff. So imported Firestore collection, created the cards view. As you can see, it's of type card. Let's just have a little more space here. We have our logic. We are grabbing the query documents for the cards view. If it's empty, present a progress view. If not, then go through all of the query documents inside the for each and then present it inside the cell. The cell is down there. On a refreshable, we are going to fetch all, and on a peer, we are going to fetch all the cards too, and the plus button created that. And then we have the delete card and the update card functions on the cell itself. And yeah, the create card, it's pretty straightforward. Yeah, I just left it in here. It's cards collection.create the card. It's as simple as that. Now, how do we actually fetch a card? So let's just go. And again, it's an asynchronous forming function, try await. And then cards collection.fetch. And now we are going to use the one with all. As you can see, we can have some predicates, and that is what I'm going to use, the one with the predicates, optional animation. Again, the default is the default animation. So let's add in our predicate, and that will be order by, there we go, a field and a value. The field will be created at, and then the value will be true. So this will just fetch all of our items in chronological order. Okay, so that is how we are fetching all the cards. Yeah, let's just go ahead and build and run. We will fetch all the cards. Currently there are no cards, but we're also going to create a new card. Let's just wait for this to launch. Here we go. Let's just select all cards. And as you can see, no cards available for now. Let's just click on the plus right over here. And we have it right over here. Card 800. Let's just add some more. There we go. Okay, so we have our four cards. That's great. How can we update our cards? Well, again, we are going to use that cards collection. Try await, and then cards collection. And then update with our updated card. There we go. It's as simple as that. And while we are here, let's just add also the delete functionality. Try await, cards collection, delete card. Yeah, that's the one. We want to delete our card. So let's build and run, and let's update and also delete some cards. Here we go. Here we have all of our cards. Of course, they are fetched on a peer. Let's add it. Why not this one? There we go. And as I can see, it just bumped it up with a random number between 1000 and 2000. And let's just delete this one. Why not? There we go. Let's build and run and see if, you know, the changes have been really made. And let's just fetch. And yeah, indeed, we have the update and we also have the missing, the deleted card right over here. Great. But this is just fetching all of the cards. Usually you don't want to do this because you might have thousands upon 10,000s or even millions of documents inside a collection. So that is where pagination comes in. That is on our final and third view, that is the cards view. So again, I just added a Firestore collection, created the cards collection. Basically it's the same thing, but now on the refreshable and on the onAppear, we are fetching the first cards. So fetching, let's say, the first three cards. And on the cell, let's just go down on the cell, we have this check if it is last fetched card. Now, why do we need this? Well, basically, when the last fetched card, let's say we have three and we have the third fetched, if that appears, we want to initiate another fetch, three fetches. And all the way down till no card will appear. If we scroll up, that last card will appear again. And then again, we need to check if it's the last one. It will be. So we are fetching again. This is called pagination. We have the delete, the update, and we have all of that ready. We have the logic on the check if it's last fetched card right over here. Basically, we are comparing the IDs of the card, and then we have this fetch first cards and fetch next cards. Now, why is this different? Why not just fetch the next three? Well, the first card does not have kind of an anchor. It's just going to fetch the first three, and then the last element will be the anchor for the next fetch. That's why we are having fetching the next card. So let's implement this. Fetching the first card, we are going to have an asynchronous throwing function, but also I'm going to use, which is optional, you might not want to use it, the state. So I'm just going to print out the state. All of these two will give you back a state, a fetched collection state. So let fetched collection state equals try await cards collection. There we go. And then if you type out fetch, you will see the fetch first or the fetch next. Currently, we're just going to go with the fetch first, and it requires a limit and an order by. Optionally, you may have some predicates, but please do not add the limit and the order by in those predicates. And again, all animation is set to default. If you want to change it, you may do so. So the limit, let's have free order over here. And on the order by, we want to have, just jump over there. We want to have created at. Okay, so we are going to order by the created at, and then not 30, but free fetched. Okay, and let me just print out our fetched collection state. For the next fetch, it's basically the same thing, but we are not going to use the fetch first. We are going to use the fetch next free ordered by created at, which is really nice. So now let's just build and run, and we should see the first free fetched, and then one, and then it's over. So let's just jump into cards right over here so we can see that. Oh, we just have three. Okay, so let's add some more. Maybe one. There we go. It's reloading. Really nice. And you can see it says fetched. We just fetched the first three. And then it says empty because we fetched the last element. Let's add some more. Why not? There we go. So we can just scroll a little bit. There we go. You can see the last one is fetched because there are a lot more cards right over here. So let's just scroll down. And then we have empty. Really, really nice. So this is how you can do CRUD operations with Firestore and with the help of my little library called Firestore Collection. If you do like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out the super sale.